Well, good evening, YouTube. I took a few still photos when I was repairing this. It was kind of hard to work on it and take pictures. I tried to leave. This is the display meter, and it has a bunch of connections. It all appears to be separately plugged in. You've got the I guess this is the current transformer connection, and then there's I think this connection runs over to the processor board, and then this one picks up, looks like, the AC output. Here's your AC output, and it's kind of interesting. They have a on-off switch, which is runs to the DC section. There's a 10 amp fuse here on the AC side, and that fuses a power plug, and then there's also an outlet here. So this says household power, and then this says AC output. So that's interesting. There's both a plug and a receptacle on the back, and then it has just a single LED. Red is fault, and then blinking green is power output, and then, like, say, the display board reads the AC voltage, current, power, and power factor. You've got the four output FETs up here, and then there appears to be two sets of four input FETs, and then two sets of transformers. It's kind of interesting because they only use 100 volt capacitors here, so I'm wondering if they run these as, like, basically a center tapped transformer, and instead of having 170 volts DC, they have, like, 0 to 100 and or 0 to 85 and then 0 to minus 85. So that's my guess. That's how they can get away with using just 100 volt capacitors.
Here's a close-up of the inductor I replaced, and you can also see the little bit of heat damage from possibly a soldering iron on a corner of that yellow capacitor.
Here's the coil I replaced. I had to clean out the traces and got it. I think the problem was the where the wires came out weren't quite straight, and they didn't go all the way through the PC board, and so when they soldered it, it was just the very tip of the wire was soldered. It was still in the hole, so I got the leads, just bent them slightly so they angled out differently, and that seems to be a much more solid connection. I'll probably try to get some hot glue and glue these down. I got the loose FET connector. One of the screws was a little stripped, so I changed it, put it over here. These are the thicker metal tabs. And then down here you've got your high voltage diodes. Like I said, there's eight input FETs, and then there's two more transistors over here. Not sure exactly what they do. Imagine they do something to sense the input polarity.
Here's a close-up of the capacitor I added. It's a Nichicon 100 volt 2200 microfarad, and it's a little bit taller than the original, so I had to angle it over a little bit.
I added a second 2200 microfarad 100 volt capacitor. It's a little too tall to fit inside, so I had to kind of angle it over. That's the original one. They use an Atmel processor here on the board. You can read the part number and everything. They haven't tried to hide that. The other thing I found was the heat shrink on the ring terminal for the negative cable. The heat shrink ran over to about the middle of the ring, which meant there was probably very poor connection there, so I cut the heat shrink back to clear the washer and the stud.
Here's a close-up of the ring terminal before I cut back the heat shrink.
They do use a pair of two 10 gauge wires here, so that's pretty decent. Like I said, the fuses are in sockets. They've got two fans that plug in here. This comes off. Pretty heavy. That's pretty heavy power and ground studs. So I hooked it up to my bench supply, gave it about 28 volts, and it started pulling some current and was doing about 20 watts or so off the supply. I can only go up to the supply maxes out at 30 volts, so I'll try hooking this up tomorrow to a one of my 24 volt panels and see what it does. Like I said, the fuses were good. I checked all the FETs. These all were like in the 500 to 600 ohm range. These were the output FETs were up in the 1 to 2 meg range. Two of them were above the 2 meg range that my meter goes to, but I guess higher resistance is better than zero resistance. So all the active components were fine. It was just a broken off choke inductor, and then I put in an extra capacitor. Figured just seems like 2200 is pretty small input capacitor, and they have a place for one. So I had ordered these last week and they showed up, so I put those in, and then I just cleaned up that input and got everything tightened back down. All the connections are tight, and cleaned up all the wires, and I think it's ready
some power
to
tomorrow.
See what it does. The display seems to work. I tried that. I'll show you that when I have it hooked up to some real power, because I can't really run it off my bench supply very good. So I'll get back to you when we got some daylight. So there's the finished unit. You've got the, like I say, the meter board on the output side. And then it's got the four, these are four transformers. They're each labeled 1.2 kilowatts. So I'm guessing, like I said, they're probably like set up like a center tapped transformer. Got the two fans. I'll have to see which way the fans blow, if they blow in or pull air out, and you got the power connector. So I think it's ready to hook up, and we'll see what it does with some sunlight in the morning. See you later then.